Anita Morgan says, is urine pH a good way to test the body's pH level? What minerals will raise an acid pH? You know, there's a lot of, it's hard to say something about this without getting trolls coming in and saying that, that urine pH doesn't reflect body pH, but a lot of people throw the baby out with the bathwater. So look, your urine pH is not going to be the pH of your blood. It's not going to be the pH of your brain. It's not going to be the pH of anything else except the urine. So the urine is not telling you the pH of your other tissues. However, the urine pH is telling you the acid burden that your body has been subjected to. And it's telling you, you can make an inference about the compensations that your body has had to engage in. And you can also make an inference about the limitations of your body in compensating for that, because even your urine pH should be buffered. It's not the case that you put a little bit of acid in the urine and then boom, your pH is going to go down. It's the case that your body has a whole bunch of systems to buffer even the urine pH as you excrete acids from your body. So the system is like in your blood, the tiniest change in your pH is immediately going to set in motion a change in your breathing rate that is going to cause you to either increase or decrease the exhalation of carbon dioxide in order to adjust the pH of the blood. And then there's going to be a longer term compensation where you're going to take some of those acids and pee them out. And when you pee them out, your kidney is going to buffer those acids in the way of preserving the urine pH. So if your urine pH goes down from 6.5 to 5.5, it tells you that your urine pH is like 10 times more acidic, but it doesn't tell you that your blood is 10 times more acidic. And so the critics of using urine pH will point that out. But what it does tell you is that your body has been subjected to a rather enormous acid burden, number one. And number two, that you're even starting to overwhelm your kidney's ability to buffer the urine and prevent the pH of the urine from changing. So it does tell you about the stress put on the system. And so I should link to in the show notes to my story about how if you Google Masterjohn urine pH, this will come up. My story about how I used my urine pH as a way to be able to start working out again. And in my case, this was because this was during the height of my barium mold crisis. And what was happening was I would work out and then I'd be flattened out for hours and I'd just lay in bed. And then I wouldn't be able to work. I wouldn't have the energy to work out again for like 5 days. And it turned out that this was because my workouts were causing too much acid load. The acid load was making me fatigued. And it was causing my urine pH to drop ridiculously low. And I used my urine pH to gauge how much bicarbonate and how frequently to take the bicarbonate to normalize my urine pH. Not so much to normalize the urine, but to normalize the stress on my body. So I'm producing lactic acid during a workout. That lactic acid, yeah, eventually winds up in my pee. But in the moment, it's fatiguing my muscles, you know? So, and I used it as a very good metric. My energy dramatically improved with repeated dose. The first time I did it, I took bicarbonate, went pee, measured my urine pH, laid back down, did that cycle like 7 times. And the moment that I felt energetic was the moment that my urine pH upon the next measurement got back up into the 6s. So I think it's very useful as a marker of the stress on the system. Now, the real goal, the short-term goal is to resolve any symptoms that could be driven by acid load, such as fatigue, by replacing bicarbonate. I don't think you want to do that long-term because I think you could hurt your digestion, and I think that you could maybe predispose to certain infections in certain tissues by long-term constant dosing of bicarbonate, at least in theory. And so I think what you want to do is use it when you need to, but then try to find what is the hole in the system that's causing the urine pH to go up. A high potassium intake would be the number one thing that would acutely affect it, apart from taking the bicarbonate. And by the way, always take the bicarbonate on an empty stomach away from food. And in my case, fixing a zinc deficiency was what allowed me to stop taking the bicarbonate. And at that time, I could have theorized that zinc would be involved because zinc is a cofactor for carbonic anhydrase, which is involved in regulating your pH level. But I didn't, it wasn't obvious to me. I mean, when I had done my zinc resources, I've never included exercise-induced acidosis as a symptom of zinc deficiency, because it's just not one of the things that stand out as a zinc deficiency issue, and yet it was for me. I had other reasons to suspect a zinc deficiency that were totally unrelated from that. And what I noticed by accident was that fixing the zinc deficiency fixed that problem. So there are probably other nutrients that I'm not thinking about at all that might be relevant that you would have to identify on the basis of other signs and symptoms or other testing that may play a role in regulating acid-base balance. And if you find that, let me know, because I'd like to know what the other things are that impact it. Thank you for your question, Anita.